migraines. Oh, I'm wearing my glasses. I know I'm wearing my glasses. This is my second channel, Nerdy Jackie. If you're new here, my main channel is Nerdy Crafter, so make sure you do check that one out as well. Today we're going to be doing a Q&A. I feel like it's been a long time since the last one, and I believe the last one was even with my sister. So I'll link that one down below as well as in the iCard section if you're interested in some sisterly stories. I mean, we do air out our dirty laundries, so... So I asked you both on Instagram as well as on YouTube in the community tab of my vlog channel, what would you like to know about me? Ask away, there are no boundaries. And honestly, one of the most interesting questions that came up quite a bit is, am I single? I will answer this somewhere later on in the video. I can't just give you the answer right away. For those of you who already know, don't say anything. Let the guessers keep guessing. So we're going to start with S. Lankis from Instagram, who asked, what material or craft genre did you always want to get into or wanted to try? I can't see the entire questions because Instagram likes to chop them. There are quite a few crafts I would love to get into, but one of them is paper making. I know it sounds completely random, but I've seen so many beautiful documentaries on paper making in Japan where they use like grass and plants, and there's these beautiful embeds on there. But I think paper making is absolutely beautiful. Maybe it's because in my genes, the Egyptians made papyrus. And so I would love to try papyrus. I have no idea how to make that. I also want to know you, Grains. What craft material or genre do you want to try? Let me know in the comment section below. The other thing I really want to try making is, you know those 3D boxes? I think they're called softbox or 3D boxes, in which it's pretty much an environment, but in 3D. I will put a picture of it right on the screen. I've seen so many artists do that at Comic-Con and Otaku-thon, and I think they are absolutely beautiful. But I'm pretty sure most of them use the Cricut, that little machine thing, and then properly put it on there and then layer it. Some of them even have cartridges. I personally own a few because when I went to Comic-Con, like, and then, of course, we ended up supporting the artist and we bought a couple because they're so cool. Lemon Light asks, also on Instagram, in your opinion, should adults watch cartoons? Heck yeah, I don't even need to finish this. I think most of us, I mean, look behind me. I think cartoons are a wonderful way for character development. Usually movies are okay, unless there are many parts. It's hard to get into the characters, you don't get to know them, you can't really, I guess, identify with those characters. So cartoons is just an animated story, and who's to say that an animated story is not as valid or as touching as movies? I mean, if we stop limiting adults to enjoying things that are childish, that's just going to be soul crushing, and anyone who believes that is probably lacking something in their life. I am making a statement. Don't limit yourself to what others tell you is the adult way of living. Because I think if I was genuinely not allowed to still love the things that make me happy, then I would be miserable. And why would I take advice from someone who's miserable? I guess identify with their way of living. That's not how we roll, Grains. Love what you love. The Jackie motto. Katten062 asks, how did you get into crafting? This is really interesting because I initially started more as an artist when it comes to drawing, not crafting. I think my earliest memories of crafting were creating blob monsters with Play-Doh. That's the extent of how much crafting I actually did, except for school and camp. So I really spent a lot of time trying to draw Dragon Ball and Sailor Moon. There were times where I was even copying from the TV. I would have the TV paused. I would get a huge transparent sheet, put it on the TV, and I think I drew Moonlight Knight. If you don't know who Moonlight Knight is, here's a picture of him. And I just traced the entire thing on a piece of paper. I know, it's so old school. That's just how I really wanted it to be perfect, because I may or may not have had a crush on Moonlight Knight. Did he have an Arabian background music playing? I think so. So it was only much, much later when I started my job teaching, and they didn't guarantee me that I would have work all year, and lo and behold, I actually got let go in the winter. So when I was let go in the winter, I found that I had quite a bit of free time, and at that time, I had already stopped doing karate because I couldn't really do it anymore. And I pretty much got into crafting because there was a competition. I lost the competition. I was like, what is this thing made of? And it turns out to be polymer clay. So I went ahead to Michael's and picked up, I think, like $50 worth of polymer clay and just started crafting. And I immediately fell in love with sculpting and clay. So that's pretty much the way I got into crafting, was when I was let go and I didn't really have any more work and I needed something to keep me busy and distracted from not having work. How did you grains get into crafting? As much as this is a Q&A that you grains ask me, I love taking this opportunity to get to know you as well. So please answer them too. Tiny Yellow Flower asks, what part of literature do you or did you teach? So for those of you who don't know, in addition to doing YouTube, I am also a teacher.
Not the boring kind. Yes, literature.
But I do have a strong preference for comic books and manga. So naturally, you can have a good guess that the genres I really prefer teaching are sci-fi and fantasy. But I take every opportunity I can to add anime and manga in almost every course that I can.
Am I a weeb?
Yes.
Do you have a problem? Come here, fight me! Come here.
I'm joking, don't fight me, I'm very fragile. Jay Nicole asks, have you ever thought about dyeing your hair? And the answer is absolutely yes. There is a wig that I own. I think I did it when I was trying to be a VSCO girl in one of my videos. So if you haven't seen that, here's some footage of me pretending to be a VSCO girl. And it's a grayish pink wig. I really dig this color. I think it looks absolutely beautiful. But the problem with my hair, in case you haven't noticed, is I constantly wear hats because my hair is just flat. As much as I try to get volume into it, it's just like, I don't have much of it. It's just very flat, very thin. So I don't think dyeing my hair for me is going to make it as voluminous, obviously. Unless I get extensions. For those of you who've had hair extensions before, are they hard to maintain? And do they come off easy? I'm really curious because I know some hair extensions, you can't even tell that they're there. They look really, really natural. So let me know, is it something that I can actually make my hair poofier? I don't even want it that poofy. I just want just a little more down here. Kaylee Sutter asks, do you support LGBTQ+? 100%, no hesitation. Yes, 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 of course. Not even a single doubt. Yes, I love you. Camila 3462. So we've come to the question, am I single? The answer to this one is no, I am married. To some of you, this might be a surprise that I am married. I know I don't wear any kind of jewelry, any kind of rings. I am allergic to metals, so I don't wear anything. And you may or may not have seen him sometimes pop into videos. Hat. The good news is that we are actually starting a podcast together, so you will get a chance to meet him, ask questions, and you'll find out exactly how we met. So we've been married for quite some time now. You'll hear the story. It's quite interesting. Now, when it comes to the questions on YouTube, we have Icy Bluebell ask, what's your favorite Pokemon? Because I still love them. You see, over there, we have Magikarp. I love Underdogs and I love Magikarp and Psyduck. These are my two favorites just because I like rooting for those that people have the least expectation from. I think it's probably because I identify this way. My teachers had no expectations of me. A lot of them told me I should quit poetry, quit art, quit acting, quit a lot of the things that genuinely I loved ever since elementary school. So I feel like I identify with these Pokemon simply because they're underdogs. There's no expectation from them. And you know what? Just, you have to give people and things the time to be able to prove to themselves. Don't look at trying to prove things to other people because they don't matter. What matters is you need to prove things to yourself, and don't be hard on yourself either. Things take time. I'm rooting for you. And then the second question is, what do you think is your best artwork or sculpture? I think I'm a little biased on that one, but I feel like the one I did for Simply Nailogical, turning her into a monster, the T-Rex, is probably by far my favorite piece yet. I spent so much time on this, working on the details. I think I was 3 or 4 videos ahead so I can make sure that I spent as much time as needed to develop this sculpture. So I have to say that one. It's my favorite. Let me know which one is your favorite sculpture that I've made. The second one I think I really like is the other YouTuber that I turned into a monster. I just love the wolf type skull aesthetic to that one. Cookie asks, What was it like living in Egypt? And did people assume strange things about Egypt? Cookie actually lived in Egypt, well, is from Egypt and moved to England. I remember when I was in elementary school, the other students legitimately thought I lived in a pyramid. So they're like, do you have a pyramid? And I didn't know how to answer that because to me, the pyramids were, there were just, you know, three of them. I was like, no, I didn't have a pyramid. But then suddenly I felt like I should have had a pyramid. And that was in elementary school. So a lot of students thought that I lived in a pyramid for some reason. And the other assumption people make is I can belly dance. If you don't know what belly dancing is, here is a little belly dancing on screen for you. No way are you going to get me belly dancing on camera. So the assumption is most people can belly dance. And the answer is, I can, but not very well, so I will most likely not be doing it. And the secret is, it's all in the knees. Kimberly P. asks, has your husband completely decided to not feature on your channel? So is it his decision or is it my decision? I believe that's the question. And as I said, Ugrains will have a chance to finally meet him in his full personality in the podcast. But it was pretty much a decision we both made because when I first started, I was kind of embarrassed having anyone watch me record. I was already shy on camera. So if someone else was there watching me be shy, then I just wasn't comfortable to grow as a creator. Also, I feel like a lot of creators put their relationship out in public if they're not healthy enough and something could happen or just too many eyes. And since when I had first started my channel, we were still also pretty new to each other, it felt like something that needed to be done pretty much privately until we were comfortable and a-okay. But trust me, more and more now, he's been wanting to be on camera with me. So I'm really excited to see how that dynamic is going to look because he's quite sarcastic. I think Ugrains will love them. Jashri Basunde asks, what was your favorite subject at school? I might not look it, but my favorite subject at school was 100% history. Not new history, nothing prior to, I would say, the 1400s. So, I mean, after, hang on. English. Please, English, I need to speak properly. What I'm saying is, I love ancient history. So ancient civilizations and lost worlds are things that just excite me. So kind of to answer another question that someone asked, which is by Marie A. What did you study in high school? By the way, I love your vids, you're the best. Thank you so much. Well, high school for Ugrains is Cégep for us here in Quebec. And I majored in archaeology and anthropology. Again, ancient civilizations, just they make me drool. I love all things ancient. And believe it or not, one of my dreams was to become Indiana Jones. Excavate and dig. And at some point, I really wanted to be a paleontologist. But things didn't go as planned, and I figured that most of these people end up being researchers rather than at dig sites. So that didn't interest me anymore, and I continued into teaching. Rockin'Romance78 asks, will we see any of your other siblings in videos? Love Sika, but want to see other salty siblings? The answer, plain and simple, to that one is no. I do have two brothers, but they are really camera shy and they prefer their privacy. So the answer is nay, you will not be seeing them. They prefer their privacy and I 100% respect that. But you'll get plenty of Sika. Lily Connor, can you do a video with Mariah Elizabeth in person? Because I love you both. Funny story is, Mariah Elizabeth and I, we were actually supposed to have a collab in person this summer. But obviously things happened. We're not allowed to travel from Canada and the US, obviously for obvious reasons. So we will not be doing our in-person collab. It was such a great idea too that we came up with together. And it was going to be fun. However, we do have a collab coming up pretty soon. So stay tuned for that. And I'm not gonna tell you when, but I will say within the next 10 days. I won't say anymore. Slate Gray, is your favorite hobby really crafting or do you like something else? The answer is, I love working with my hands. But one of the things I really love doing and I just don't have enough time doing is gaming. I genuinely love gaming. I did start a gaming channel and I just put a trailer on there, but I just don't have the time to game and I really want to. And I feel like I need to give myself more time to game, to relax, but then I'm thinking of the gaming channel that I started, but I didn't really do anything with it yet, so. Gaming is something I really want to do more of, and drawing, and traveling. I want to do so much. Glaisner, if you could master one art medium, what would you choose? I would probably choose doing alcohol-based marker type art. Kara, I did not forget you. I've been wanting to use this kit. I promise, I really want to use it. It's actually on my desk all the time because I'm trying to remind myself I need to use it and play around with it. If you grains are interested, my friend has a kit with Spectrum Noir, which is a alcohol-based marker set. So if there's any one medium I would love to develop way more, it is 100% alcohol-based marker. I have a huge collection and I want to draw all the things that I just see and the environments that I see in my mind and the characters. I just don't have the skill because I don't practice. Evelyn Bersiaga, this is a really good question. I think you'd be surprised what the answer is. Are you proud to be a YouTuber? Why? Not that I doubt your answer, I'm just curious. There are times where I'm really happy to say I'm a YouTuber, but at the same time, I actually never say it. My colleagues at work at school have no idea I'm a YouTuber. Some of them know, they tell others, but it's really a tight-knit circle that really know. Otherwise, I don't go around telling anyone, just because many of us YouTubers have a bad image in the media. They paint us in a really bad way. So like we're irresponsible, we're having parties during these times. So there's just this negative connotation to being a YouTuber. So I don't really tell anyone unless they already know and then we can just talk about it. Otherwise it's like my Batman identity. Last question for today. I know there are so many questions, so I feel like I should be doing these monthly, or maybe we should be adding them to the podcast. I think that could be really fun too. We're going to end on the note, what is your favorite anime? I am so obsessed with My Hero Academia and favorite character is All Might in both his small and big form, but mostly small. However, one of the animes that I absolutely adore is so underrated and it's called Ancient Magus Bride. If you're into fantasy type fiction, but also a little bit of romance and action, it's a little on the weird side. It's great. It's really wonderful. I would recommend Ancient Magus Bride. That's all the time we have for today. I would love to do more of these because you grains have so many interesting questions and it gives me the time to get to you to know you grains more too. Remember, if you want to see the previous Q&A with my sister, check over here. Until then, I will see you in the next vlog.